can't hit someone. Jim jata hai na.
First, we are all locked down. I know the lockdown is relaxed a bit, but it's always important to exercise that social responsibility. So you are home, I am home with my cup of coffee. So I first cheers you with this.
My cup of coffee.
Cheers. I would begin with this book post that you had done, where you posted this book, by Suketu Mehta, This Land Is Our Land. And you talk about the issue of migration very subtly. You don't say much and you just put it out there for people to just read between the lines. And it's so well done for me that it actually stayed with me. Yes.
Okay, so basically what I feel is that there is a whole lot of books which has been written on a whole lot of important issues. And what I feel is that different people have different ways of putting their points across. And for me, it is about what I have read and how I could put it out there, you know, because the same topic of conversation for someone else matters very differently, and for for someone else matters very differently. So for him, it was all about the migration to the US, and you know, a whole lot of us and our families who we know stay outside this country, and at that point of time, what made them go there, whether it was for studies and then they settled down there, but it is a form of migration. So migration also has various kinds of levels. And what is this whole migration? The whole part aspect of migration is because you want to have a better living. You want to have hope. You want to live in conditions which are better than you feel. So at various levels. So I felt that book really resonated to me. And for some reason that year, a whole lot of books in some way were talking about this very important conversation. And it just happened to be right now in some form. But Amitabh Ghosh in Gun Island has very briefly spoken about migration. Yeah, and he's talking about the Sundarbans, and he's talking about how people travel, and you know, how they go to places like Italy and make a living there.
Venice,
and
yeah.
We have all seen that, you know, we have all seen that, and we do not know what happens inside there. So that was a good learning for me. So yes, there are a whole lot of intelligent authors out there, and also people who really care, I would say. The thinkers who cared, who make a difference through their writing. It's us to pick it up and, you know, say, this is what it is. So,
yes. And why I mentioned this book also, Ashwini, is because, you know, there is so much that is happening with the migrant issue in our own country. We see so much on how these people who really do not, who are not as privileged as you and I, have had to suffer so much. So, and that's why I mentioned, so here is where I'll talk about the filmmaker in you, the visualizer in you. The way you suddenly put that book, you know, in your story post, your films also have been pretty much like that, where you talk about these issues. You talk about a lot of things which are family, which are love, which are things which are taken for granted. And you put it without sort of that grandeur and floss, and yet, you know, it is so impactful. And you have been doing that. Whether it is Nilbatte Sannata or it is Panga, for that matter. So is it a conscious sort of an effort? Because one thing that I take back from your films are very strong female characters, and that has become sort of a given and synonymous with you. But and yet you your story really, you know, stays for much longer than after you have seen the film.
You are just like... have you read my mind somewhere? Is because I always say this thing is that for me, movies, you know, when someone asks me, how is your project going? I just hate that word project. It's because for movies is a part of my being. And for me, it is about working on something which will last forever. It is for the archives. So that is what movies are for me. And it is also my way of doing a little bit of social service to society, is because I do not know what other way could I tell my stories and create some kind or of afterthought in in my audience, and this is a large audience I'm talking about, because if my movies are not seen in theaters, maybe they would be seen in online platforms, or maybe they would, and it will always be there in some place. There was a journalist who had asked me this question, that you know, a whole lot of filmmakers talk about politics in their films, and why you don't, you know, put that part out there. And for me, it is politics of the mind. Whatever we do is all on the mind, and therefore the mind functions in a way, and that's how we behave in a certain way. So whether it was Nilpate Sannata about a social issue, about a daughter who doesn't want to get educated, is because she stays in a kind of society which where she's grown up seeing that there's only certain things I can do, and this is where I am going to be. And you have a mother who tells her that, you know what, you are not going to be here, you're going to go beyond where you are.
Yes.
Which talks about a very intriguing thing, and it happens in every class of society, I would say, is that no matter where you are, who you are, or where you come from, you have the right to dream.
But tell me something.
It was about going and having a good education, is because that's not been done. And for me, maybe it is my mother being a teacher, staying in a very small place in Mulund, now not very small, but that time very small in Bombay, and getting now into making films, which was not, because we are a family of teachers, professors, IITians, so that's what it was. So from there to have no background and then come and make films is something which I aspire to be. So it breaks those barriers.
Talking about breaking barriers, why is it that when there was a female director on the block, so to speak, they looked as not directors but female directors? Why is an achiever not really called just an achiever in your case? Why is she called a woman achiever? I mean, why is that stress on the word female so much? Like, you know, it's not really a normal thing for women to go ahead and achieve. And I'm sorry that I'm talking like this in a time like this, because I'm sure you on your film sets would have faced these things. Because I was reading one of your interviews where you said that I was shooting in Agra, and logon ko pata hi nahi tha ki bhai female director ko kaise bulana hai, to wo sir bol rahe the mujhe. You know, instead of calling me ma'am or whatever, calling me by my name, because they are not used to, you know, the boss lady, so to speak. They're not used to women calling the shots. And I'm talking about, because you've made films which are in the tier 2 cities also, like Bareilly Ki Barfi for that matter, even Nilpate Sannata, where you're talking about the sort of lower middle class, lower income group for that matter. So how much do you see that still? And you, I know the dialogue is endless, but still happening.
It has changed quite a bit. Nilpate Sannata is shot in 2005. And before that, I was in advertising for about 16 years. I never faced this thing in advertising, is because that was a very corporate job where people are used to seeing women in that kind of roles.
Yes.
But it was still, and there was one time when we were told that we need to hire more women, is because there were a whole lot of guys in the creative section. But we had clients who were a lot of women. I was working predominantly on PNG, and we had so many clients of mine on Whisper and Tide and many other brands who were women. So I never faced this thing. But when I came here, what happened was, I think it was a whole paradigm shift where when you see a more workforce which consists of yin, which is the women, then people start getting used to it. So that's what it was. And then 2015 and 2016, I shot Bareilly Ki Barfi. The same kind of line producer was there, because I was shooting in a very similar location, right?
Yeah.
Agra was shifting to Lucknow and Bareilly. And they didn't have a problem. They didn't mind that thing. It's because after that, the shift had happened to an extent that he came and asked me that his daughter wanted to get into direction and what she should do, you know? So it is people like us, I feel, that who belong to this classes of society, I would say middle class, and we have to open the doors for far many girls to come out there and achieve what they feel they wouldn't be able to do. So whether it's a pilot, for the longest time, I still remember that when we used to sit in a plane and when we used to see a woman who's a pilot, we would like actually be very excited about it, and there were also doubts.
Yes.
It was the same thing even for driving. that definitely a woman driver, therefore gadi.
I feel that I don't want to be. I feel females are the most responsible drivers, but हाँ ये cliche हमेशा होता है अच्छा लड़की गाड़ी चला रही है.
Exactly, but now it's no more. It's because people are they are used to getting. There was a time when I don't think so. We ever got calls from car companies for loans or even for that matter for home loans or any loans. We never used to get those calls, and now we get it all the time. It's because there are decision makers which is going in the hands of the woman. Like Sheryl Sandberg said it very nicely. You know, she had gone in for a meeting. She's from Facebook, and she had gone in for a meeting with one of her clients, and she wanted to use the restroom, and she asked where's the restroom, and the people there said that there is no restroom for women, and she said okay, and she came out and she said that I don't want to work with you guys. It's because this is what it is. The same thing applies to me where I went for my post-production somewhere right now and for Panga, in fact. And I was doing my post-production in Bangalore with a very amazingly set up for post-production house for my VFX. And the first time I went, I asked for where's the bathroom. And he was a very nice gentleman who told me that, ma'am, next time you come, I'll fix a bathroom for you. And he did that. And he told, and I asked him, what is the problem? He said that not many girls work here, because it's a back-end place and not many girls work here. We have girls, but they work in the more admin section. And it was true. I've entered into a room full of computers, more than 50 computers, and it was all men. And I smiled back, and he sent me a message saying that, we're going to have a state of art facility, and I promise you, we are going to have a separate bathroom. So I think it is for us. He said, I told him that you do not make it, I'm not coming next time. But the work is ready, but I'm not going to work with you if that's the case.
Okay. Okay. Before you finish, since it's coffee time with Griha, and before you finish off your coffee while we are chatting, I have a little game for you. Okay. So you can hold your coffee cup. That's my own version of Never Have I Ever. And I'll just ask you to take a sip if you have done it, whatever I'm reading out to you. You will have to take a sip if you have. You will tell me the story behind if you have done whatever. So let's begin, all right? Take a sip if you have an onset superstition. You do. What is it?
No one else more than my first AD and my DA will tell. And if she's listening to this, if I have a recorded version later, she will laugh at it. Is that I do not like clocks and calendars in my set. So you see any of my set, any of my houses, any of the films across, there will be no clock and there will be no calendar.
Why is that?
Because I have the superstition that a clock. So you bolte hai na ki ek band gadi ghar pe nahi rakhte hai. For me, my set is my real house. I'm living, breathing that house every day. For me, it is not a set. I shoot in real locations. Right. So before the house, we set up the whole house, and my art director Sandy has literally put agarbatti, and we used to get into the house, and we used to feel as if we are staying there. So that's my thing. That the people of that house are my characters, and my characters are as real as the house they are in. So a bangadi or calendar. Calendar is for this because I feel like किसी ने कुछ गलत कर लिया एंड डोंट चेंज द डेट और यू आर सीइंग समथिंग व्हिच इज ओल्ड आई डोंट वांट दोस काइंड ऑफ मिस्टेक्स टू हैपन
ओके या
एंड दोस मिस्टेक्स आर वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू रेक्टिफाई बिकॉज आई विल हैव टू गो इनटू पोस्ट प्रोडक्शन एंड क्लीन इट अप एंड दैट इंक्लूड्स अ लॉट ऑफ मनी आई डोंट वांट टू गेट इनटू ऑल दोस थिंग्स बट क्लॉक डेफिनेटली यस अगर क्लॉक रखा भी फॉर अ रीजन लाइक इन पंगा the kid switches off the alarm of the clock.
Yes.
So that was the only shot I had kept in there, and it was a work clock at that point of time.
Okay. All right. Take a sip if you can't take away the South Indian in you. I have already asked this question, but a South Indian trait that you still stick with. What is that?
I drink a lot of coffee. Bareilly ki barfi. Navratri time we are shooting there, and we were staying I think in Marriott. All of us are there, and I still remember Ayushman, the hardcore Punjabiness in him wanted like good Punjabi food. And me, I befriended the chef there, such a sweet guy. And I happened to be from Pune. I said that, can you make me dahi chawal and sambar rice, please? Sing it. Coincidentally, my DOP also is from Chennai. Was from Chennai. Is from Chennai.
Yeah.
And so we found this. We kept finding, but no one could actually make the good South Indian, like, you know, the dahi chawal. It was very hot, so we wanted to just eat the dahi chawal in the afternoon. And you always eat light, you know, in shoot,
yes,
especially in the afternoon, because I don't want to upset my stomach. I don't want anything to happen which will start affecting my brain. And then finally, we found this place in Lucknow. A South Indian place, I think banyan, banana leaf or something like that, I have no idea. But it had the best dahi chawal, and my production person used to every day get dahi chawal from there and make it and give it to me.
Okay, that's nice. Alright, take a sip. If you have been totally smitten by the casting in one of your films, like all the actors.
Smitten?
Yeah, completely smitten. It could be any reason. It could be the looks. It could be the body of work. It could be their acting. Anything.
I've been smitten by all my actors. Whether it is Swara Bhaskar as Chanda.
Yeah.
Or whether it is Ayushman Khurana and Rajkumar Rao and Kriti Sanon in Bareilly Ki Barfi. Whether it's Kangana Ranaut, Richa Chadda and... Neena Gupta, and also Jassi Gill, and also the kid in Panga, or Amla Paul in Amma Kanakka, the Tamil remake of Nilpati Sanata. I've been smitten by, and Revati, of course. I've been smitten by all of them in some way. It's because sometimes they get magic onto screen which you must have never thought. You know, and sometimes it's also the kind of person they are. Like, for example, now I can talk about it. Like, I told you that, you know, to gym jata hai na, to maan nahi sakta. Isko. You know, I was laughing to myself today because it's really long. What, 2018, 16? Now, it's what, 3 years now.
Yeah.
I was telling this to Ayushman Khurana. Ayushman Khurana is such a wonderful human being. He's a really dear friend of mine also. That I don't think so he can really hurt anyone. And even if he has something in his head, if he has something against someone, he would never tell it, you know. He's a person with such a good heart. And I was telling this guy to on screen, because that was the first time he was playing a role which was very, like, you know, the little teda fellow, but still has somewhere a good heart, but you will fall in love with him later on.
Yes.
Because itna bura bhi nahi hai, par hai to ekdam kameena hai. So, I'm telling this person to hit him, and he's like, and I said, you go to the gym, just throw your anger on him. And he's like, really, he'll be okay, right? He's telling Raj, tum theek rahoge na? And Raj is totally in his character. You can see Raj is like fully in his character. Maro bhai, maro mujhe, no problem nahi, mujhe maro. So that was it, you know.
Yeah.
Also, mostly I've been smitten by all my actors is that because I treat my actors as my friends, you know. They are my family.
Yeah, yeah.
They are a part of me, and I talk to them so much that I don't call them actors. I just call them a part of my family and my being, you know. And as in, when you keep talking to them, it is like staying in a house, and sometimes maybe you would find someone who's not in a good mood, but everything you can see through the camera.
And what is it with your, like, the nicety in all your actors, whether it is Swara, she never wanted to hit the child, or it is Ayushman who never wanted to hit
the child. Yeah, Swara didn't want to hit the child, and she hit her and she started crying. I said, this is the scene, this is my pre-climax scene, and here you're supposed to hit her. And the way you scream, you're very good at screaming, but what happened? Why can't you just give her a slap? And she said, oh, I mean, that little girl, how can I slap her? And she started crying after that slap. Because the girl went red. And see, because I could not do this. The moment I do this, I did a little bit of later in terms of after effects. But she had to still give. That is because otherwise that girl won't react.
Yes.
She's still a first-time actor. She won't react. And
she's quite spunky. I remember interviewing her at that time. Yeah.
and she will not react. And after that, she like hugged her and she said, "Love, come, let's go out for ice cream today." And I said, "Take me also for an ice cream." So my thing is that I get so close to my actors that for me, at that point, I also was very this thing, but I have to behave like, you know what?
Yes.
You are an actor. Can't you do this also? And yes. I was laughing is because I didn't want her to. I also didn't want to show that emotion. So there are times when, if you talk to any of them individually, I think you see so much through them, and also you have to empathize with actors. You know, they have a life, and they have a real life, and they have a real life, which is so true. It's because there might be some problems at home, or there must be something which must have happened, or there must be some work issue, and they have to leave everything on the spot the moment they come in front of camera. And that's difficult. And sometimes you can see it through and sometimes you won't see it through. But most of the time I see it through, and then it's like, you know, this playing around that.
Okay. It's important. Yeah. Okay. So take a sip. Now this is a cue. You've given me a cue to my next one. Take a sip. If you have ever had a secret admiration for one of your actors, or you've had a bias. And I'm not talking role-wise. Role-wise.
No.
Never. Okay. All right.
Everyone, including my secondary actors and everyone, like for me, all of them are like just there. Yeah.
Well, given you the, oh my God, this guy is so cute, I would probably, you know, let him be on the sets a little more, probably leave him early.
Oh no, I think I'm above all that now. Maybe if Mr. Bachchan is there, I would just tell him that, you know, why don't you just be here a little more long and let's talk a little bit more. Because he's an icon and you look up to him. So, otherwise, no. Maybe, I used to like when Nina Gupta used to be on set is because we used to talk a lot more than films, you know.
Yeah.
Life and
family
and, you know, a lot of things. So, that discussion used to happen. So, I think it's all of that conversations, yeah.
All right. Okay. Take a sip. If you never thought that Nilbate Sannata will give you the kind of recognition that it actually did.
It's a very in-between thing.
Okay.
It's a very in-between thing is because I was working on a feature film for the first time, but I was not new to the art of making films or telling stories is because I had a past which was that, but in shorter format. The reason I wanted to tell Nilbate Sannata was because I wanted the story to reach far many people than I would have done in advertising.
Correct.
And that's why I took that leap there. So I've never measured my films through success is because that is there's this whole thing that you are a creator of a story. You started off as a creator. Then the whole thing became something which money is put into, right? And then it has a economics which works around it. So that economics, for me, maybe it doesn't matter. But for someone who's putting that money, matters a lot. So, you know, there's a very correlation which is there. I always say this, that if I start thinking that today I'm making a film and I need to make so-and-so numbers, I think it'll be my wrong starting point is wrong. Yes, I need to think about what are the kind of numbers it will make. But if I start thinking of that first and go reverse, then I'm going to make a film which will be only tick mark for the numbers.
Right. Okay.
So finally. Between... a good film, a great film.
Yes.
Good storytelling and great storytelling, there is a difference. So our mechanisms and our filtration for films cannot be judged by box office. It's because box office numbers no one knows.
And brilliant, I like this, yeah. That's a very good answer. Yeah. And it's a very thoughtfully that you've actually put it because, you know, you wouldn't really think about it or think of it. Not many people would perceive a filmmaker to be thinking on those lines because ya to wo sochte hain ki acha film banate aapko laga tha ki ye successful hogi, you know, beech mein lagne lagta hai. That's the only, I mean, that's how peripheral it gets. And they don't really give so much of thought to something like this. Acha, ab yeah, this is the final one. Take a sip if you've had an actor openly or subtly hitting on you. It could be. I mean, not just your. I mean, not just an actor that you are directing. It could be anyone.
No.
Never? Come on. That's a pity.
I don't think so. Even if someone wants to hit on me, can hit on me really is because I think I give a lot of bro vibes. My vibes only are very bro. I have a lot of guy friends than women friends.
I could see that. Gym nahi jata hai, maro isko, toh that was like totally
like right from college days. And I don't know. It's very like I can talk to guys about anything and it'll be a very bro vibe kind of thing.
So tell me, I mean, now there are two ace filmmakers in the house. So who plays the AD? Ghar pe, dono mein se, AD kaun play karta hai?
We have a very very silent I know what you're doing kind of relationship. Which is basically that we go on auto mode, and I think this is the longest time we've stayed together in this lockdown,
because I'm sure most couples will say that
that 3 months is quite a big time to stay together.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
And we patted each other's back saying that, hey, you know what, we know each other long enough now, 17 years to just go on auto mode. So, and we have been on auto mode forever now, even when we were working in the agency and even now. And also the beauty is that both of us are very strong in our own piece of work in communication.
Yes.
So
yes.
I, because of my art director background, and he, because he's a writer predominantly, we really balance that out really well. And then both of us get into the writer thing, and then each of us have our own direction styles. Thank God for that, is because our direction styles are very different. But our soul is the same. So when a soul is the same, and we both know that we are not here to compete with each other, and we're only here to grow and support each other, that's great. It's because when I started off with Nilbade Sannata, that time there were not many directors who, women who were doing, who were directing. And then, of course, being a couple director, two directors at home was maybe one in a million kind of thing.
Yeah.
So it was very strange, you know. Sometimes I used to read comments. You tend to read comments, and I stopped reading comments totally because I don't care right now. Is that, oh, definitely the husband must have helped, and that's why she's here. You know, yeah. These kind of things always come up, and this is a mentality which is so incorrect. Is because no one would ask him that, did I help? I'll not say did I contribute in Chiller Party, or whether in anything in Dangal or in Bhootnath Returns. There's so many things, like, you know, as two people staying in the same house, you discuss, and those kind of contributions always happen. That doesn't mean that we are into taking each other's work. It's just that contribution happens with anyone. So just because you read the book doesn't mean that you write the book also, right?
Correct. And you've also mentioned about the two most important people that you met right before you entered the lockdown, and you happen to be working on a film on them. So would you like to actually throw some light there also? The Narayan Murthy.
Mrs. Sudha Murthy and Mr. Narayan Murthy are extremely inspirational people. And I feel that if ever I have to retire, then I would retire with a hope that I one day become like Mrs. Sudha Murthy, which I'm not even like an ounce of the kind of work she has done and what she is as a person. It's because unko moh maya se koi lagav nahi. I sometimes ask her, you know, that you do so much of work, but why don't you talk about it, right? In this world, in this kind of time, even if anything you do, people talk about it. Like, you yourself talk about it, and that you need to have a certain kind of perception. And she told me that you don't need to talk about it. That's something which you keep doing. And whoever has to notice will notice. And for who are you doing? Are you doing it for yourself? Or are you doing it for people to notice that you have done it?
Mm-hmm.
And I feel that those words really resonated with me, is because for me also, I felt that for long people didn't know that it was me who had made those films. Mm-hmm. And I was known later that, okay, you know, oh, have you made this film? It's beautiful. Mm-hmm. And Nitesh used to feel very proud of some of his friends. He said, oh, your wife has made that film. I really like it, you know. And I think it's okay to be that way. But okay to be that way that you are known by through your films mm-hmm. than anything mm-hmm. else. And she is that. And so mm-hmm. is Mr. Narayamurthy, who had a vision of not to be the best in the country, but to be the best in the world representing the country. And I think that's mm-hmm. the most awesome thing any human can think for, that you think for your society, you think for what you can do for others' well-being more than mm-hmm. yourself.
Mm-hmm. The fact that you also say that people did not really know that you were part of those projects and you were actually the brain behind those films. Does it still happen? Do you think that the audience really doesn't care? Because jaise maine pehle bhi bola, there is so much of emphasis between you know, who's a female director and a male director. We don't really call a director male director if he's a man. Do you think the audience, you know, they lay such an emphasis ki who is the director, whether he's a female, he's a male or she's a female? Do you think that is there?
No, I feel that audiences don't go into a theater seeing whether it's a female director or a male director. Half of the time, they don't even know who the director is.
Do you think it still happens? Because there are more and more filmmakers
for the longest time. Now, of course, they know. Thanks to the internet, thanks to all the social media, thanks for us to have our social media handles that everyone knows who a director is, who the music director is, who the writer is, which is so important. Now an audience is going to a theater to watch a film knowing that these are the people behind that film. As much as the front of the camera is important, very important, the behind of the camera has also become important.
And since you're a filmmaker, I have to ask you about your favorite film or one film that will be your sort of go-to sort of space that you would want to go back to when you'd watch it n number of times. Which will be that film?
So, let me be very honest. I, more than watching a film n number of times, I like reading books a number of times, is because for me, when I read books, I start visualizing a space versus watching a film where I would maybe watch it for the technique or, you know, what, how it was made, because my mind goes into that direction unless I put it in a space where I say that I'm only going to watch this film because I want to watch this film. Therefore, I really like some films, Woody Allen films I really like, Midnight in Paris I really like, I like Sai Paranjpe, Basu Chatterjee, I think his films are really, really good.
Yes, yes.
Hrishikesh Mukherjee, these. And if you ask me one film which I really want to go back to, I really like watching Pursuit of Happiness again and again.
Oh, yeah.
Because that is one film which in the end, the way he reacts and, you know, what he talks to himself and this particular time, this time of mine is called Happiness.
Yeah.
Is something which I really like, and I feel it's an important thing. Otherwise, there are so many films which I keep going to, and right now there are a whole lot of these web series which I started liking a lot. There's so many of them, and which I'm watching, which is from Sweden, from Canada, and there's some really nice ones where the world is moving in a different direction. So I also start getting this feeling when I'm watching films or all these web series, and oh god, I need to make something like that. So I stay away from it a bit, because then my mind starts functioning, and then I made this message, one producer said, oh, why do you think we can do something like this? Something like this is already so much of work. And Nitesh told me, one more idea for